the best negotiators in the entire world. They don't know how to take the word no. They know they, you know, they just kind of work their way around mom or dad or whatever it takes. They know how to work it to get yes. Now, what happens to us? So at what age do we finally start taking no for an answer? It's almost like we go to this reversal thing. We're open, we're creative when we're small, and then all of a sudden, after we've had people tell us enough, no, no, you can't do that, no, no, we stop searching. We stop stepping outside of the box. We stop asking.
Getting people to use their full potential is a challenge for all industries. Debra Pestrak helps organizations, teams, and individuals work more effectively, become more persuasive, and close more sales. Debra not only shows people what to do, but also, and more importantly, she teaches them how to think. She brings her knowledge, humor, and interactive, inspiring style to each presentation.
I wanted to know, what is it that these people all have in common? Because I believe in what's known as modeling, which is where you go out and when you want to be the absolute best at something, you go out and you check with the best, you observe the best, you see what they're doing, how they're doing it, and then you do it too. And from doing that, you also can get the same kind of results. The thing is that you don't have an opportunity too often to observe the best in the business, do you? So that's what I'm bringing to the table to you for you today. What is it that the best do that you should be doing?
We believe in modeling, which is looking at the best and taking from those people and implementing those things in your life. You can't help but be more successful. So I talked to them about the challenges that they had. What was their success formula that enabled them to be so successful?
And that's what my program is about, is teaching people how to get what they want in life and what are some of those key strategies, these key skills that will make your life a lot easier and will allow you to be more successful in no matter what it is that you're doing.
In 1985, I was broke and miserable. Absolutely.
And I'm thinking
miserable
to myself,
this is stupid, Deb. Come on, what do you got to do to change? And one day I was standing in my office and they were announcing the people that were going to the leadership event. Now, in case you're not familiar with that, what they do is they take the top producers, they send them off to a luxurious all-paid vacation. And this particular day, I'm standing in my office going, I'm waiting to hear my name. I'm not on the list. My first response was, wait a minute, I'm as good as they are. Then I had to step back for a second and say, Deb, if you were as good as they are, you'd be on the list. So what does that mean? Does that mean I'm an average performer? I go, I'm not an average
performer.
None of you in this room are average performers. So I thought, well, what do they have that I don't have? What is it that they're doing that I'm not doing? And it prompted me to start doing massive research on what do top producers do that I could start doing. And after 2 years, I reached the 1% of the income bracket in the nation. Now, what was the secret to that? It was the doing part, wasn't it? So many of you know what you should be doing, and you're not doing it. It's the doing part, being in the now and doing what you need to be doing to get to where you want to go.
Here's the secret, though.
Leveraging people, systems, and marketing. These are the three keys to success in any business. And these superstars have figured out how to leverage themselves, systems that they're working with, their marketing, and then they all have built a winning team.
This is one of the absolute most critical things you've got to know. Spend 80%
of your time doing the 20% that drives the most revenue.
After I got done interviewing these superstars in real estate, I said, okay, what could I implement in my own business? And I said, well, I'm an entrepreneur, you're an entrepreneur. This is all about being an entrepreneur and how you can be successful as entrepreneurs. So I took what I learned, I implemented it in my business, and I doubled my net income in 4 months. Now, I know if I can do it, every single one of you in this room could do it. You can. Now, I thought I was pretty successful in my business. So I have to tell you that it actually shocked me that by using the things that I learned from these people, that I was actually able to do that. And it was like, wow, and not only that, I enjoy what I'm doing a lot more, too. So what I found was, there's no secrets, but there is secrets. Now, isn't that a fascinating thing? Meaning that what you should be doing is no secret. But the order of which you do them in, there's the secret. And the reason I say that is I jumped out there and said, okay, great, what did I learn from these folks? Let me implement it. And it cost me thousands and thousands of dollars in the mistakes that I made.
How many of you have a target market?
All right?
The rest of you who did not raise your hand, you need help. Somebody needs to sit down with you and help you figure out your target market. Because if you do not know your target market, you will waste lots and lots of money on your advertising. Because you're not going to write the right kind of ads. You're not going to do the right kind of marketing. Because you're trying to market to everybody. And it just doesn't work. It's a waste of time and it's a waste of money if you don't know who you're trying to get to say yes to.
You
can decide that you're going to wake up at 6:30 in the morning and with 5 minutes either way, without an alarm clock, you can wake up. All right? That is the epitome of controlling how you think. Do you use it in the rest of your life? We just talked about the self-talk that we have going on. Well, superstars and top producers control how they think. They can have a bad day, but they move on from that bad day. So, do you let go of the things that happen in your life? When you fail at something, do you learn from it and then let it go? Or do you carry it around with you?